Hey there, my friend, welcome. My name is Dr. Anthony Balduzzi. I'm the founder of the Fit Mother Project and the Fit Father Project, and I want to welcome you to this really special video on weight loss for women over 50. This is one of the most important videos on our channel, and this is a very deep dive video. We're going to teach you what my team and I have used to help over 10,000 mothers and fathers and their families lose over 100,000 pounds of fat using these six simple principles in this video. So if you're looking for a 2-minute quick fix weight loss scam video, this is not the one you're going to want to do. But if you want to stick around for 10 plus minutes and learn the fundamentals of the stuff that's actually going to help you lose weight and keep it off as a busy woman over 50, this is your video. Stay tuned. I know you're going to learn a ton. So get out your pen and paper, take some notes, and let's dive on in. All right, so when it comes to weight loss for women in their 40s, 50s, and 60s, the first thing we need to look at is what is the state of your metabolism? Because let's just not beat around the bush and let's face the facts. It gets harder to lose weight as we age. And a main reason of this is that our metabolisms tend to slow down as we get older. In fact, when we're in our 40s, 50s, and 60s, we typically burn around 200 to 350 less calories per day than when we did when we were in our 20s. And this may not seem like a whole lot, but it does add up. I mean, over the course of a week, those 300 calories times 7 is almost around 2/3 of a pound. So if we eat the same way we used to, and we use the same approaches we used to when we were younger, we're gonna find that we're frustrated. The weight doesn't seem to come off, or we may even be gaining weight in the process. So we gotta understand that there's some metabolism changes that happen as we age, and this happens to both women and men, but women in particular, there's also some hormonal changes that happen, because we're in our mid-40s, especially when we get into our 50s and 60s, we're in this perimenopause and menopause period. And the main thing that happens in the female body is that estrogen levels start to decrease. And estrogen really does play a large role in affecting a bunch of other hormones when it comes to our metabolism. In fact, when estrogen levels go down, our insulin sensitivity goes down, which is insulin's a key hormone that helps us process sugars and carbs. So we become a little more resistant to carbohydrate intake. So this is another thing that can make weight loss a little more challenging. So I don't want to make this all seem like bad news. We just need to really face the baseline facts, because when we get into the tips 3 through 6, we're going to talk about what we can do to offset these things. And trust me when I say, if you're a woman in your 40s, 50s, and 60s, you can lose all the weight you want. It's 100% possible. We just need the right kinds of strategies. But we don't actually start with diet and exercise. And this is a big mistake that a lot of women make when they want to lose weight, because they think it's just going to be the next diet and the next workout plan. The number one place we need to start is the proper mindset. Because if we're being honest, and this is not just like a soft foo-foo tip, weight loss is a behaviors game. A lot of us know that the salmon is healthier than the burger on the dinner menu. It just comes down to getting us to order the healthy meal on a regular basis. We know what healthy foods are. It's like, how do we make sure we eat those things consistently, don't slip back into old patterns? A lot of this weight loss stuff comes down to mindset and psychology. So the first thing we do with all the women on our Fit Mother program is we get them to write a 30-day weight loss mission statement that outlines the reasons why they want to lose the weight on a deep level. And so that requires a little bit of introspection and reflection. So take a minute right now and go through this with me. Why are you motivated right now to watch this video on YouTube and lose some weight? What are your big reasons? So I imagine there's some physical reasons. You want to fit into that dress. You want to lose fat in your, maybe your midsection, your arms, your thighs, your butt. You might have some specific cosmetic reasons, and those are amazing. We want to do that stuff. And what are some of the other reasons? How is carrying the weight affecting your confidence? How is carrying the weight affecting your ability to be a good parent with your kids? How's it affecting your job? How's it affecting your finances? When we start to really realize the big picture, we can get some psychological leverage on why losing weight is not just a thing that would be nice, but may even be a must for us in our health. And I know for me, the reason I started the Fit Mother Project and the Fit Father Project is I saw my dad get sick, not take care of himself, and die at 42 years young. And then I watched my mom struggle to keep our family together, and her health suffered as a result. So for me, this weight loss stuff is far more than cosmetic. It's like, this is the foundation of what almost ripped our family apart, and it's why I'm so committed to helping busy moms like you get the weight off and keep it off. So for you, what are the big reasons? You gotta find your motivation, because let's face it, in 2-3 weeks, when you're on the healthy eating plan, things are gonna get tough. But if we have a deep emotional bedrock to come back to, and we know why we're gonna be losing the weight and why this is so important, that's gonna give us strength to persist. Because this is a consistent woman's game. We don't just wanna lose 10 pounds and regain it all back, we wanna keep it off. So when it comes down to a mission statement, journal on some of your reasons and write down your mission statement. It might look like something like this. I, Susan, am committed to losing 15 pounds in the next 2 months because I know that my weight has been something that's affecting my confidence level and I'm setting a bad example for my kids. And I know by getting this weight off, I'm gonna feel lighter, leaner, I'll love myself more, I'll feel so much more confident. And it's gonna increase my ability to be a great mom, to be great at my job, and it's gonna really make sure that I have a body that can serve me and last for 20, 30 years into the future, period. Something like that. Print it out, stick it on your fridge, put it in your car, put it on your bathroom mirror, reference it daily, it's that important. Next step is another mistake that a lot of women make when they try to lose weight is they focus on diet and exercise without first getting their sleep in check. Most women don't know that sleep, especially when we're in our 40s, 50s, and 60s, is the foundation of weight loss. Sleep is like the master clock that controls all of our main weight loss hormones, controls cortisol, controls insulin, controls thyroid hormone. When we're not getting enough sleep, we're basically shooting ourselves in the foot when it comes to our weight loss efforts. And what the research shows is women who do not sleep enough and then go on diets end up losing muscle and not fat, and it makes it more likely that they gain weight after they stop the diet. So we gotta get the sleep in check. And what this typically means is a minimum of 7 hours of quality sleep. And I'm talking about quality sleep. If you're having kids wake you up, having a dog wake you up, or you're getting up to pee a lot throughout the night, we gotta audit your sleep and get it of higher quality, because otherwise, all the stuff we're about to talk to on the diet and exercise is just not gonna work, because the sleep, the poor sleep, keeps your body in a constantly stressed state. We have some articles linked below on how to sleep better, the connection between sleep and weight loss. There's some really simple things you can do, like wearing a face mask, putting earplugs in, decreasing the temperature of your room, and drinking some herbal teas at night. We have all those tips in the articles below, but I wanna give you the big picture in this video. And so sleep, just know, it's actually more important to get on track than diet. Now the next priority ends up being healthy eating, because let's face it, you cannot out-exercise a bad diet. And a lot of women think that to lose weight, you need to go get on the treadmill, get on the elliptical machine, go to that yoga class, start lifting weights. And that is just not true. Let me repeat this. You do not actually need to exercise to lose weight. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't do that approach. We want you to exercise, but just understand that a healthy eating plan is the foundation, because when we're losing weight, we want to create a calorie deficit. And it's so much easier to not eat 500 calories than to spend an hour on a treadmill burning 500 calories. That makes sense, right? So it's like a medium fry at McDonald's, 450, 500 calories. Let's skip that and not have to spend an hour on the treadmill. And then the exercise that we're gonna do, and I'm gonna show you in the special kind of exercise, these MRT workouts in step 6, are gonna help our benefit. So when it comes to healthy eating and nutrition, we have a lot of deep dive training for you. It's linked in the description. We have a full free Fit Mom meal plan that will email you. That's absolutely amazing. They'll show you exactly what to eat for breakfast, lunch, snack, and dinner. In this video, I'm gonna give you like the big picture of some stuff to start. The first thing I want you to think about when it comes to nutrition is the best diet for you is the one you can stick to long term. Meaning a couple things. One, it has to be convenient. It can't be overly complicated. It can't be like eat this weird superfood every 1.5 hours throughout your day. I imagine you're a super busy person like me, so you need something that's sustainable. So that almost begs number two. The second tip is we need to set your meal timing in stone. I want you to start getting proactive where you know every day you eat at 8, noon, 3, and 7. And that's just an example of one of the different meal timing setups that we have inside our Fit Mother program. That's the on-the-go setup. So if you're out of the house really early for work or taking your kids to school or whatever you do, having a meal at 8, eating roughly every 4 hours later at noon, having a snack around 3, 4 p.m., and having dinner at 7 is one meal timing setup. Or you could do something like our at-home meal plan, which is a more intermittent fasting kind of framework where you might shift back that first meal, skip breakfast, and have your first meal at 11, have a snack at 3, have a dinner at 7. All of these different meal timing setups work. The key is to find the one that works for your schedule. So of those two that I proposed to you, and we actually have 5 inside our full Fit Mother 30X program, we need to find the one that's gonna fit you best. So what do you think is gonna be a good meal timing setup? Take some notes, jot this down. Are you a breakfast person? If so, maybe you're gonna want that on-the-go plan with the 8, noon, 3, 7. Do you not really care about breakfast and you wanna try this intermittent fasting stuff? Then let's try that. But we gotta get your meal timing in stone. And then when it comes to actually what do you eat during those meals, a really simple thing we teach here at the Fit Mother Project is this concept called building perfect plates. So when you have these perfect plates, it's really simple. You fill half of your plate up with any kind of green veggie you love. So that could be steamed broccoli, it could be salad mix, it could be asparagus, Brussels sprouts. You fill a quarter of your plate with some kind of lean protein you like. And this could be animal proteins like an organic chicken breast or grass-fed beef. Or if you want to eat on a more plant-based vegetarian, this could be something like organic tofu. It could be like a more higher protein lentils and beans and legumes and something like that. And then the other quarter of your plate is going to be some kind of carb you love. And this is important because right now there's a lot of people talking about super low carb diets, ketogenic diets. They can be very effective. We're fans of them, but I need you to know it's not necessary to cut out carbs to lose weight. Women on our Fit Mother program lose 20, 30, 40 pounds in 2-3 months while eating carbs every single day, including bread. So I need you to know that you do not need to be overly restrictive to get the weight off. Carbs can be a part of your plan, especially if you like those. And that's why this perfect plate concept is so effective, because it makes things simple. When it comes to breakfast, what might this look like? Well, you might have a side of greens with one or two slices of a high quality, either gluten-free or regular toast like Ezekiel bread, a couple eggs, and a slice of turkey. That could be a great breakfast. For lunch, it might look like a big salad with some protein on top of it. For dinner, it might look like a cup of rice with some chicken breast or some salmon with some greens on the side. So there's so many different options. And when you understand this perfect plate concept, it gives you a wide variety of the different foods you can do. And again, we have a free Fit Mom Jumpstart, which not only gives you our full one-day weight loss meal plan for busy moms, but it also gives you our workout program that's linked below in the description. It's 100% free. If you want a deeper dive into nutrition without making this video 1 hour long, check that out. Next thing after healthy eating is understanding the importance of daily activity. And notice we did not call this exercise, and the research supports this, that good sleep plus a healthy eating plan plus daily activity is all you need to lose weight. In fact, we have one client who does not exercise at all. She just follows our meal plan and she takes a daily 30-minute walk and she's lost over 50 pounds. You do not need to work out to lose weight. It is helpful, but daily activity is more important. And the reason is because daily activity helps our brains actually control our hunger and appetite hormones and actually make sure that our circulation is working properly. It's not about the calories burned, it's about the fact that our bodies and our metabolisms work better when we reach this minimum activity threshold. So for most women, I say that's around 5,000 steps per day, around 30 minutes of daily activity. And the research also supports that if you do a walk after you eat a meal, almost immediately after, you get an even better weight loss benefit than if you did it at a different time. So the timing of this stuff can matter. So doing a walk after meals, even if it's like 10 to 15 minute walks 3 times per day to get your 30 minutes total, is perfect. It's not like you have to do this all in one setting. You can spread it out. We got to make sure your body's moving, especially if you sit at a desk job or you're driving your kids around in the car all the time and you're on your butt. We know that sitting, they're calling it the new smoking. It's one of the worst things we can do. So we got to get you up and moving. So if you're at a desk, let's get up. Take some steps every hour. You know, park farther away when you're at the store so you can get more steps in. Accumulate steps throughout the day is key for weight loss with a healthy diet. And once we have strategies 1 through 5 in place, we're gonna get to our final tip, which is all about the kind of exercises you should do. And the single best weight loss exercise for women in their 40s, 50s, and 60s is called MRT workouts, which stands for Metabolic Resistance Training, which is a combination of the best strength training exercises using weights with cardio all in one time efficient workout that takes 30 to 45 minutes. Women in their 40s, 50s, and 60s need to lift weights. It is perhaps the single most effective kind of exercise. And it's really a shame that so many more women don't know about this and have led to believe that you need to do aerobics or lots of cardio to get the body you want. Women need to strength train, especially as they get older, maybe even more so than men. Because what happens as we go back to number one with the metabolism decrease and the fact that when we're around perimenopause and menopause, estrogen levels goes down, women's muscle mass tends to go down. Bone density goes down. Strength training fixes both of that and it increases your metabolism. So what strength training is gonna do for you, it's gonna help you build that lean, toned, shaped muscle that gives your body the look it wants and also burns more calories 24/7. So when you strength train, you start to build that muscle, your metabolic furnace is gonna be cranking and that calorie deficit where you're burning fewer calories than when you're in 20s can actually be accounted for with the proper strength workouts. So what is MRT workouts? Well, we have a full free MRT workout below and our free Fit Mom Jumpstart where we actually give you our meal plan too, plus these MRT workouts. But in a nutshell, essentially what it would be is taking some of the best exercises for you as a woman in your 40s, 50s, and 60s, like squats, deadlifts, shoulder presses, and rows, and we're gonna put those in a circuit with very little rest in between. So we might go straight from squats, straight to shoulder presses, straight to rows, straight to deadlifts, 5 to 10 reps of each, and then we rest. and then we repeat the circuit. These MRT workouts are amazing because they only take 20, 30, 40 minutes, depending on how you set things up. The one we have for you in the Fit Mom Jumpstart is a 24-minute workout that you want to do 2 to 3 times per week spaced out, because every workout can boost your metabolism for up to 24 hours after a single session. So you do one on Monday, your metabolism's boosted. You do one on Wednesday, metabolism's boosted. Friday, boosted. So you have a constant metabolic boost effect. Normal cardio does not do this. You need to lift weights to get this effect. And trust me when I say it's not like you're gonna lift weights and turn into Arnold Schwarzenegger. Women just don't have the testosterone levels to put on muscle that rapidly, that quickly. What strength training will do for you is shape your legs, your arms, help you get rid of belly fat, get your butt to lift. It's absolutely amazing what strength training can do. And here are some pictures from some of our women inside our FitMiller 30X program who have started a strength train and their bodies shape up and they look absolutely amazing. You can experience this for yourself. But again, the purpose of this video is to give you the big picture. We need to start with understanding the reality that our approach needs to be different because you're a woman in your 40s, 50s, and 60s. We need to get the proper mindset. We need to discover your why you want to lose weight, and write that into a mission statement. We want to make sure your sleep is on point. We're going to get you on a healthy diet that is simple and sustainable. So that means it's based on proper meal timing and it's not overly restrictive. Then we're going to get you walking for 30 minutes a day that can be spaced out. And then we're going to do metabolic resistance training workouts 2 to 3 times per week. That's all you need to start losing weight. Women following these exact guidelines are losing 20, 30, 40, even 100 pounds on our programs. And this can work for you, but as a woman in your 40s, 50s, and 60s, you need to have the proper plan that's tailored to your body, to your metabolism, and your busy life as a busy mom. We are the Fit Mother Project. My team and I are dedicated to helping busy moms like you get and stay healthy for life, especially as we get older. So we're so happy to help you. So I'd recommend as a next action step from watching this video is to scroll below, check out that free Fit Mom Jumpstart, and we're actually gonna give you our best resources 100% free. We'll email them right to you. You're gonna get a meal plan, you're gonna get a workout, and I'm actually gonna give you our full mission statement guide too over the course of 3 days. It's an absolute amazing resource, and it's part of our mission to make this free for more moms who wanna lose weight and get healthy, because that's why we're here. So thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. Drop us a comment below to let us know some of your comments and your questions, stuff you learned, and if you really enjoy this, we love your feedback. And definitely subscribe to our Fit Mother Project YouTube channel. We're growing like crazy. We have dozens of videos on the channel right now, and we're about to get into the hundreds on the best diets for women over 40 and 50, the best workout plans, how to get and stay motivated, how to get your husband, your spouse, your kids on board with you. We cover all this here at the Fit Mother Project. We are the health and fitness experts for busy moms and women over 40. We're so happy you found this video. So subscribe, hit like, drop a comment below. We'll see you around the channel, and I'll talk to you very soon, my friend.